All right, we are live. We've got Dirge of Cerberus. Bought this PS2 just so I could play this game. So that's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and turn the audio off on the TV there. Let's pull up our Twitch, make sure it's working.
It's just guiding them to a
wow, Critical Role is up right now. Critical Role is so cool. But yeah, let's look at my channel real quick here. Make sure it looks like it's working. We want to make sure
it's working.
Yeah, we can hear some shit. That's good. Okay, game start, tutorial menu, extra features. Extra features, what do we got? What do we got? Event, character, art gallery, and extra missions. Okay. I guess. So we're going to put a pause on Crisis Core. Because I've been playing through it. And I'm like towards the end. And I'm having some issue with like my adapter or my PSP. I don't know what it is. I guess I could try another game. But let's see our tutorial menu. I don't listen to anything you just said. TTT explanation 1. Come on now. There we go. Alright. This hurts my eyes. Oh, dipshit. extensive FPS experience. 100% me. I've played all of the FPSs. And the game was like, nah, you need to be on normal. The game told me I sucked. All right, let me go to the bathroom. I'll be right back. Okay, well, I think that we're gonna okay. Here we go. We're starting a new save file, Dirge of Cerberus. I do kind of think that I want to play the end of Crisis Core. Maybe I'll watch, I don't know. Yeah, I don't really know anything. Let's do it. Okay, good. I can pause that. I remember the Sea of Flames. Oh, you know what?
Hey man, it's Adam. I just wanted to call and talk to you about Barber High.
Yep. Okay, we have no audio anymore. I think it's because we are muted. I think I'm all muted up here. Yeah, there we go. There we are. Okay. And then we need to come back over here. There we go. Sweet. Okay, and we're back at it. Had to take a little work phone call. What time is it? 3:53. My cat wants some food, but it ain't freaking food time yet, homie. All right. Now I do have a strategy guide for this. For this game. And I wonder if I shouldn't go ahead and grab it. I mean, I don't think a strategy guide is needed, but I just really enjoy strategy guides. Like the old school, you know, back in the Dizzy. Old RPGs of like go everywhere to you know, make sure you don't miss out on any items or anything. Oh, I should have fucking stayed up there. Let me go back up. Let's see if it shuts it off on me or not. See, we went this way. Where is this now? It's calm. So what did we pick up by coming? Okay, see, we got a potion. There you go. There you go. Oh, we don't have the other weapons at all yet. Well, that makes sense then. Yeah, let me see here. Where's the strategy guide for this game? Not even sure where I put it. All right, I got it. So our Dirge of Cerberus strategy guide here. Freaking love like Final Fantasy strategy guide stuff, man. Freaking love it. But yeah, let's Oh, okay, hold on. Prologue. The following contains a plot summary of the video game Final Fantasy VII, as well as the movie Final Fantasy VII Advent Children. These events take place prior to those from Dirge of Cerberus Final Fantasy VII, which is not discussed in detail here, to avoid spoiling any of the story for those who have not yet played through the game. The legendary heroics of Cloud Strife and the members of Avalanche will never be completely forgotten. But like all memories, good and bad, their tale has faded with time. However, it has taken more than just time to undo the damage wrought by the Shinra Company and Sephiroth. The survivors of Midgar have rebuilt their lives in the city of Edge, located on the outskirts of the ruined metropolis. Although the life stream is slowly replenishing itself deep underground, all is not well on the surface. Nearly 2 years later, Cloud and his longtime friend Tifa Lockhart work together running the Strife Delivery Service, while also taking care of children orphaned during the Genova War. Even as time passed by, some things never changed. Cloud still had not come to grips with the past and still couldn't forgive himself for the deaths of Aerith and Zack. Even surrounded by supportive friends and children in need of his guidance, Cloud continued to shut himself away from the world around him. What nobody realized was that Cloud had good reason to seek solitude. Like many others in the City of Edge, he had been inflicted with a disease known as geostigma, brought on by the presence of Genova cells within the body. Knowing he couldn't even save himself from the disease, Cloud didn't have the confidence to face the sick children who looked up to him for help. At one time, he had that strength. However, that was a long time ago. Almost exactly 2 years after the defeat of Sephiroth, Cloud was forced to find reason again in his life. While standing at the Buster Sword placed as a grave marker for his friend Zack, three unknown men on motorcycles attacked Cloud without warning. Soon after, at a meeting with Rufus Shinra, who is driven to restore the planet and restore his company's name, Cloud learns that the young trio is led by Kadaj, who seeks the remains of Genova. Together with his two brothers, he wishes to use Genova to resurrect Sephiroth and finish the destruction of the planet. Kadaj begins by taking all of the geostigma-infected children to the forgotten city of the Ancients. Cloud, armed with a new sense of purpose in life as well as a new array of weapons, heads off to the Forgotten City to take on Kadaj and bring back the children. However, Cloud fails to free the children and ends up being rescued by an old friend, Vincent Valentine. His self-doubt continues to spiral downwards. It isn't until Kadaj and his cohort summon the colossal dragon Bahamut, Sin, that Cloud finds the strength to keep up arms again. Fortunately, he is not alone. All of Cloud's allies who fought with him in the past appear in the City of Edge to join the battle. Together with the unique skills and determination, Cloud is able to overcome his weaknesses and slay the dragon. With his spirits restored, Cloud then charges into battle against Kadaj. The fierce duel with Kadaj stretches across Midgar and takes them to the church where Aerith once tended flowers. Inside, Cloud is healed of his geostigma when water infused with the power of the life stream appears from below the church and falls upon him like a gentle rain. Cloud, with his body restored, gives chase again, and the battle shifts in his favor. Just as Kadaj is about to receive a fatal blow from Cloud, his body takes on the form of Sephiroth, and he deflects Cloud's attack with ease. The battle continues, and Sephiroth begins to overpower Cloud. However, an opening in Sephiroth's defenses gives him just the opportunity he needs, and Cloud's newly improved Omni Slash cuts the sinister spawn of Genova down once and for all. Sephiroth's form reverts back to the body of Kadaj, who is at the edge of death. Aerith's spirit once again appears and releases a healing rain across the land that cures the geostigma plague. Story continues. 1 year has passed since geostigma disappeared. Hold on. Yeah. 1 year has passed since geostigma disappeared from the world. Although Cloud has come to embrace his circle of friends in Edge and forgive himself for the past, the constant loner Vincent Valentine has yet to come to terms with himself. He harbors suffocating regrets from working with Shinra as a Turk and blames himself for what happened to the woman he loved, Lucretia Crescent. The long years of isolation endured beneath Shinra Manor had not erased the pain of his guilt, nor had the time spent with Cloud and the others. Dirge of Cerberus, Final Fantasy VII, is the story of Vincent Valentine and explores the cause of his grief and self-loathing. Vincent is an expert marksman and possesses superhuman strength as well as the skills necessary to excel in all forms of combat. Although Vincent can utilize some magic, it's his ability to transform that represents his truly unique strength. Vincent's limit break enables him to take on the form of creatures such as the Galleon Beast, a reminder of the cruel experiments performed on him by the scientist Hojo so many years ago. Taking on the role of Vincent, players will battle the menacing forces of Deep Ground that have risen from the ashes of Midgar after being forgotten by those who experimented on them for so long. Deep Ground is after Vincent, who they believe is the key to locating the mysterious proto-materia that is crucial to their ultimate objective. Fortunately, the World Regenesis Organization is there to help him. With the aid of old friends from the past, Vincent must combat the devilish forces of Deep Ground while simultaneously overcoming the even stronger demons residing in his mind. And then it goes through the characters here, and it has Vincent and Lucretia, Reeve, Kate Sith, Shalua, and Yuffie. And then we have Shelk and Azul. We have Rosso, Nero, Weiss, Hojo, Cloud, Tifa, Barret, Cid. Okay. So they didn't even... Yeah, I guess they have everybody in the game. Yeah. We could go through these characters a little bit too here, I guess. Okay, Dirge of Cerberus Final Fantasy VII is the complex story of Vincent Valentine, one of the allies who came to assist Cloud Strife in his epic battle against the Shinra Company and Sephiroth in the incredibly popular Final Fantasy VII. 3 years have passed since the so-called Genova War, and although Vincent briefly lent another helping hand to Cloud during his battle with Kadage in Advent Children, Vincent has spent much of that time alone. Like Cloud, Vincent carries a heavy burden of guilt along with an unhealthy obsession of seeking revenge. Vincent's tale, as told in Dirge of Cerberus Final Fantasy VII, involves many characters, some familiar, some not, and organizations. It is our goal that this chapter not only provide you with the biographical and gameplay-related information that readers expect, but that it also clarifies the complex relationships that exist between the characters. Vincent Valentine. Vincent is the main playable character in Dirge of Cerberus. He was a hidden character in Final Fantasy VII. Located in the basement of the Shinra Mansion, players learned about his 23-year slumber. Vincent relies heavily on the use of long-range weapons, or guns, and prefers none more than his triple-barreled handgun Cerberus. In addition to being an expert marksman, Vincent can also transform into the creatures known as the Galleon Beast and Chaos. He's 6 foot tall, he's about 30 years old physically, and occupation is unemployed and ex-Turk. Biographical highlights. Former member of the Turks, the Shinra Company's special operatives unit, charged with protecting the company's executives, scouting for potential soldier candidates, and carrying out espionage and assassinations. The son of Grimoire Valentine, an important research scientist who worked on a project funded by the Shinra Company. Grimoire died over 26 years ago in a laboratory accident, but Vincent never learned the details of his death. Vincent was assigned to protect a beautiful scientist named Lucretia Crescent and fell in love with her despite her reluctance to get close to him. It was Lucretia who found Vincent's dead body and performed the experiment on him that gave him the form of chaos. Lucretia. She's dead now. Lucretia was an ambitious research assistant assigned to work with Grimoire Valentine, Vincent's father. Her zeal for research and defending her thesis led to the untimely death of Grimoire in a laboratory accident. Later, when Vincent was assigned to protect her and Professor Hojo during the days of the Genova Project, her tremendous grief resurfaced. Reeve. He's 38, and he's the WRO commissioner now. Reeve is a former Shinra employee who was charged with overseeing housing and urban development. These days, however, he's the head of the World Regenesis Organization and serves to protect the world from all future attacks. Reeve pretends to not know who his financial backers are, but fans of Final Fantasy VII know to expect it to be Rufus Shinra, the shamed son of the former Shinra president. Reeve is known to fans as the master of Kate Sith, who used this likable animatronic cat to spy on Cloud's Avalanche group. Reeve, much to his credit, always cared about the everyday citizens of Midgar and eventually joined forces with Avalanche to overthrow Shinra. Now, as head of the WRO, he continues to fight the good fight and is a helpful friend and confidant to Vincent. Kate Sith. Kate Sith is the talking animatronic cat controlled by Reeve He is a master of disguises and worked as a fortune teller in Final Fantasy VII. Nowadays, Cait Sith spends his time with Reeve assisting the WRO. Cait Sith is the only other playable character in this game besides Vincent Valentine. Players can look forward to putting his short stature and spryness to use in a stealth-based mission during the main story mode and also his combat skills in some of the extra missions. Shalua. Vincent encounters Shalua in Edge during the assault by Deep Ground. Shalua is a workaholic devoted to spending her days with the WRO in hopes of finding her long-lost sister. Shalua has spent many years fighting toward that goal and has lost an arm and an eye in the process. Yet she forges on, confident that one day she'll be reunited with the sister she failed to keep close so many years ago. She's 24 years old. Yuffie. Of all the other members of the main Avalanche group from Final Fantasy VII, Yuffie is the only one besides Vincent who makes a prominent appearance in this game. In many ways, Yuffie is the glue that has helped keep the group together, as she has remained in contact with Reeve and Cid and keeps tabs on the whereabouts of everyone from Vincent to Cloud. Although she has grown out of her thieving ways, she is as clumsy and talkative as ever. Yuffie will come to Vincent's aid, just as he did in Midgar 3 years earlier, and will be there to watch over him every step of the way, even if it means getting airsick on Cid's new ship. She's 19. Shelky, the transparent. Shelky is the computer expert of the Sviets, assigned to assist Azul in tracking down Vincent Valentine and retrieving the proto-materia. Shelky has been linked through the World Network and with the personality data of Lucretia and uses Lucretia's memories, knowledge, and emotions to know where to look for Vincent. She also begins to feel what Lucretia feels, and as they say, emotions can sometimes get in the way. Despite having an amulet that keeps her forever, keeps her body as that of a 10-year-old, she's actually 19, she fights with the sophistication of someone twice her age. Her ability to create a magical shield and superior athleticism makes Shelky a formidable foe. I'm actually not going to go through any of these other people real quick here or right now because we haven't been introduced to them in the game just yet, so I'm going to wait on these four other people. Hojo. Professor Hojo was responsible for a lot of the problems facing the world over the past several years. He was the man whose experiments caused the birth of Sephiroth. He was responsible for Vincent's death so many years ago, and even injected himself with Genova cells to assist Sephiroth in his mission. Fortunately, the members of Avalanche were able to mortally wound him during the Genova War. He's dead. He used to be a scientist. Cloud Strife. Although Cloud continued to harbor feelings of guilt concerning Aerith's death, his triumph over Kadaj in Final Fantasy VII Advent Children helped him find resolution and move on with his life. Cloud makes a small appearance in the game, along with his futuristic motorcycle, Fenrir. He helps lead the ground assault on Deep Ground. He's 24. Tifa Lockhart. After helping Cloud set up his delivery service, Tifa got involved with the displaced youth of Midgar and opened up an orphanage. She keeps in close contact with Cloud and Barret and remains the steadying force she always was, or at least tried to be. Although she has a small role in this game, she remains as likable as ever and continues to show the traits that always made her such a great friend. Barret Wallace. Barret was happy to get a new prosthetic gun after the events of Meteor Fall. Armed with this new limb, pun fully intended, he left in search of a new energy source to replace Mako, leaving his daughter Marlene in Tifa's care. Barret's enthusiasm remains strong and he happily leads the assault on Midgar by driving one of the Shadow Foxes into battle. Although his role is small, fans will no doubt enjoy seeing Barret shouting in his same old way with Tifa riding shotgun. Somebody texted me here. I want to check on it real quick. Okay. Sid Highland. Sid hasn't changed a bit. He's still the best darn foul-mouthed chain smoker this side of Gaia. After marrying his former engineer, Shira, he sought fit to name his next ship after her. Sid's new airship, the Shira, is a wonderful piece of machinery and proudly leads a WR air division into battle against deep ground with it. Okay, there we go. This is all the freaking... Sea of Flames. 3 years have passed since Vincent was plucked from atop the exploding Mako cannon in Midgar, and he spent most of that time alone thinking about his former love, Lucretia. Then one day he receives a message from Reeve, the former head of urban development for Shinra, who eventually joined forces with Avalanche to help protect the planet. Reeve is now the head of the World Regenesis Organization and needs to speak with Vincent in the town of Calm. The message comes just as a news report appears on television concerning the discovery of an underground wing of the Shinra building in Midgar. It is said that thousands are believed to have once been used in vile human experiments performed by the secret sector of the Shinra Corporation. Vincent arrives. Anyways, Vincent arrives in Calm in conjunction with the town's festival celebrating its reconstruction. But as he sits by the window of his room waiting for Reeve to contact him, he's startled by an explosion. A large contingent of unfamiliar soldiers are ambushing the town and massacring the residents. Vincent is slow to involve himself, but the pilot of one of the enemy aircrafts forces the issue by opening fire on Vincent from close range. So, look, I already missed this, like, frickin' memory capsule thing. There's a memory capsule. This is why we have strategy guides. I didn't even know there was a memory capsule. I wonder what a memory capsule does. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, that's pretty cool. So I wonder what that means. Stage mission. Well, I'm a little confused. Oh, that was up there, I think. Okay, that goes to column one. We're in column two now. Okay. Mission 1-1. Interesting. Well, I don't know. They just killed all of them, huh? I was shooting the fucking guy. You know, I hate shit like that. Like, I was fucking shooting a guy. And the game's all, meh. Whoops. We missed a memory capsule. missed a bunch of memory capsules. This motherfucker. think we'll probably just leave it right there. Yeah, I think we'll just leave it right there. It's a good little start. But I also have to pick out. I'm going to play Gabriel Knight. It's like my old game right now, my old Sierra game. And then I need to find another one. Another game to play too, so we'll see what happens. I'm also like kind of in the middle of trying to find some good like animes to watch, maybe animes. Rick and Morty's I'm about done with, so